Hi there, this is Chris from Laptastic. A few days ago I posted a video explaining how to measure the speed of a car using the free motion analysis tool tracker. This video was the first of a tutorial series and you're right now watching the second. This time we're going to analyze my walking style. Let me first show you the clip I took with my smartphone. Okay, let's get to it. I'm planning to work speedy this time because it's somewhat a repetition of the steps already covered in the last video. However, if you're unfamiliar with tracker, I strongly recommend you to watch the first part of the tutorial in order to catch up. Okay, now let's launch tracker. And then let's drag and drop the video into the main view. You remember from the previous part of this tutorial that I've got problems with the MOV format on this computer, so this video has been converted into the MP4 format. Now we need an image scale. I jump to the part of the video where I can properly set it. In this case, I will use my own body height. Okay, I say new calibration stick, I zoom in, then I drag and drop the ends of the calibration stick to my head and my toes, then I set the length of the calibration stick to 1.76 meters. Okay, that's it. I can hide the calibration stick now by clicking here and zoom to fit. Remember that the calibration stick has the line the same plane where the motion you want to study takes place. Okay, next I select the region of interest of the video that is relevant for the analysis. Let's jump here. Okay, that's me. Okay, I hit the play button. I'm going to start here. That's 1892. That's the frame number. Let's go on. Okay, and let's stop at 1990. Okay, I say clip settings, start frame is 1890, and we are going to end this region of interest at 1900 and what was it? Let's say 90. That's 100 frames. That's maybe a bit too much, so let's use a step size of 2. So I'm going to see every second frame. Let's jump back to the beginning of the region of interest and hit the play button. Okay, I'm going to analyze this portion of the video. Now on to the coordinate system. I bring it up by clicking here. I think for starters I will use the line I drew on the ground. So I move the origin of the coordinate axis here and rotate the x-axis so that it points to the left. That means that I expect the x values to be increasing. Okay, that's it. I hide the coordinate system and I am ready for the next step. Next step is tracking. I say track new point mass, then I zoom in. And now the question is, should I click on every single frame or should I try an auto-track? I think given my special haircut, I could try to auto-track my ear. I say mass auto-tracker and now I do control shift and you see the cursor has changed and I'm going to click on my ear. Now that's the feature tracker is going to look for in every single frame. I say search next. Yeah, found it. Okay, I think I'm ready and I say search. And there it goes. Okay, 100 frames have been processed. I zoom to fit again. I close the auto tracker window. I jump back to the beginning of the region of interest and hit the play button. Okay, looks good. Now we are ready for the analysis. Let's look at the Y graph first. You clearly see while walking my head goes up and down and up and down again. I'm not sure if this is normal. Please try it out and let me know in the comments. You see there's a slope in this diagram, in this graph. Let's get rid of that. Let's bring up the coordinate system and rotate it in order to have a constant amplitude like that. Okay, now we can read the values. This is 1.61 meters down to 1.66 meters. So my head goes up and down by 5 centimeters. You know what? I think it would be an interesting challenge to let the students walk trying to prevent this up and down motion of the head, keeping it at a steady height. I'm sure they would love it. How long does it take me to make one step? In order to find out, I give a look at the time axis. This is 0 seconds, this is 3 seconds. So in 3 seconds I make 1 step, 2 steps, 3, 4, 5. 5 steps in 3 seconds, 3 divided by 5 is 0.6. So it takes me 0.6 seconds to do 1 step. What is my walking speed, my average walking speed? In order to find out, I give a look at the x graph. This is the distance in x direction versus time. As expected, we see a linear increase of the distance with time. Okay, we can make a rough guess. This is 3 meters, this is 3 seconds, so it's more or less 3 meters in 3 seconds, which should be 1 meter per second, slightly more. But we want to know for sure, so we do right click and say analyze. This brings up the data tool window where we have again our table, we have again our data points. And we want to do a linear fit on these data points, because we know the slope in the linear fit is the velocity. I could choose a subset of data points, which I'm not going to do right now. I will use all of them and say analyze, curve fit, line. Line means linear fit. And we give a look at the fitting equation, which is x equal a times time plus b. A is the slope, so A is the velocity. And A is how much? It's 1.276, so it's slightly over 1 meter per second. Okay, this was the second part of my tracker tutorial series. I hope you liked it and find it useful for your teaching. If you don't want to miss the next episode, please subscribe and ring the bell. See you soon.